she, but are you a virtuous woman?
That's a good question. Like, who?
Yeah.
Who can find a virtuous, like, and then examine what virtue really is?
Yeah.
And these moral codes. Like, when moral codes get broken, that's where's the virtue in that? There's a lot of we need to, as opposed to think about self-preservation, we need to think about preservation of our people.
Yeah, which that starts right there. So it's like, you have some people that really don't have it or don't see that. They don't see that as being a thing, or they might, as at that point, they haven't gotten to the level where, and who know where the world would be, but they haven't got to the level where they can see that, okay, I actually am a part of an individual nation inside of this, inside of America, blah, blah, blah. Some people are really just American.
Yep.
And
that's what Joe was talking about the other day. He was like, hey, y'all, this is, he's like, this the answer. This is me paraphrasing it in all words. And he's like, I got the answer. It's really not a male-female problem. It's a nigga black folks problem. It's the niggas against the black folks. Mm-hmm. And I totally understand that ideology. A nigga gonna be a nigga whether it's a male or a female. He's gonna try to take advantage of whoever he can do. He gonna come against his people. I totally see that ideology. It's like, definitely.
Like Django.
And he said, wow. So we do better when we start pairing the people that's alike, like-minded, put them people together and see the ones that are the niggas and let them be on over where they are. And then
because when you dissect that movie, the main villain was not the plantation owner. Nope. And I mean, I don't see nothing wrong with that movie. That movie, how that white dude wrote that stuff was like,
yep.
Because that was not the main antagonist.
Exactly.
The main antagonist was Samuel Jackson.
Yep.
He's the one that figured it out, figured out the plot, this, that, went back, alerted. He was, the nigga was the main one.
The main power and the main antagonist.
Yeah.
Do you see that?
The main power.
The main power and the main antagonist. So he wouldn't have been cheap without the power of the main antagonist. Cause like you said, it was the perceptiveness of this man. Who that nigga on his nag?
Yeah.
Like, it's his perceptiveness. He can say it however he's saying it, but literally, it's his perceptiveness that's making you wealth. It's his perceptiveness that's giving you the skill set to maneuver, because you did it for my daddy and you doing it for me.
Mm-hmm.
Right? So, man, that's deep. That's deep. The main antagonist and power. He utilized the power of the antagonist.
Mm-hmm.
The power of a black man to be the main antagonist and the destroyer.
Mm-hmm.
And the one that was still the last. He was like the last to have to get shot.
He was the last. He was the last. Yes. That's the crazy thing about it.
And he was in love with this man.
Oh yeah, he was in love with his white slave owner.
He was in love with his white slave owner.
Yep.
When that man shot him,
completely dedicated, because he is the actual definition of a nigga. He does not want to see everybody else succeed. I got into this position. I have held my power because I was born in this position, and I'm about to rain down on my own people. I'm gonna exploit my own people. So I can be comfortable, so I can be in this position, so I can do whatever the heck I want to do.
Ooh. And them is them niggas.
That was crazy. That how we just did.
Right.
Yeah. What? He was not. The slave owner was not the main antagonist. He was not the main villain.
Nah.
He was just another character. He was on the villain side.
Would not have had as much power.
Nope. He would have been
or figured out the plan.
Yeah, he would have been deceived.
Yep.
So the main villain was the nigga.
Yep. The main villain and the main power. And so that's deep, because that is the same blueprint that gets used.
Yeah.
because I have to use your type of power against you.
Yep.
Ooh. I have to use your type of power against you.
Mm-hmm.
What are the faces that I put in to break your stuff up? They gotta look like
you. They gotta look just like you.
But they not you. They them niggas.
Exactly.
Baby.
Hey, really going back to what Joe said. There's a difference between
them.
Nigga. The and Aboriginals.
The Aboriginals. Yep.